Wednesday, the buses came rolling in once again to begin the 2017-2018 school year. This year, the Brashear Tiger was on hand to greet all of the returning students. The day began with an assembly in the gym where Mrs. Shipman greeted the returning students and introduced members of the BHS faculty, including new music teacher, Mr. Jeff Wick. After going over school rules, the classes were dismissed to go to class meetings to elect this year's officers. On Thursday, the Lady Tigers softball team played their season opener as they hosted the North Shelby Raiders. North Shelby got on the scoreboard first with a run in the top of the first inning, but Brashear took control of the game with a 5-run second inning and led the rest of the way in a 13-5 victory. Avery Acton had 3 hits for Brashear, Hannah Reeves, Alexa Higgins, and Hannah Grissom each had 2 hits, and Tana Garlock also had a hit. Acton got the start on the mound, pitching a complete game and striking out 11. On Wednesday, an assembly was held for the student body to hear speeches by the candidates for Student Council President and Vice President. Hannah Reeves and Levi Blankenship were running for President, and Cammy McGinnis was running unopposed for Vice President. Voting was held during lunchtime to determine the winners. Congratulations to Levi and Cammy, our new Student Council President and Vice President. On Wednesday, the KTVO crew were here to present an assembly called Just Drive. 2 speakers told their own personal stories of the wrecks that changed their lives. The program emphasized the importance of using good judgment behind the wheel, as well as always buckling your seatbelt. Lady Tiger softball team was at Linn County Friday night. Brashear got on the scoreboard in the second to take a 3-0 lead. They would never look back as they went on to blank Linn County 11-0 in 5 innings. Tana Garlock and Hannah Reeves each had 3 hits for Brashear. Megan McHenry, Avery Acton, Alexa Higgins, and Hannah Grissom had 2 hits each, and Callie Altide also had a hit. Acton went the distance on the mound, striking out 4.
The Brashear Tiger baseball team kicked off their fall season at Linn County Friday night. The Mustangs got on the scoreboard with a pair of runs in the first. They followed that with 1 in the second, 4 in the third, and in the fourth, 1 in the fifth. Meanwhile, the Tiger bats were mostly quiet and Brashear was shut out 10-0. Garrett Hausman had a double and Zane Sykes singled for Brashear. Sykes got the start for Brashear with Hausman pitching in relief. The Lady Tiger softball team was in Milan Monday to face the Wildcats. The game turned out to be a slow-scoring nail-biter. Milan pushed across a single run in the first, and Brashear answered with a run of their own in the third. Although both teams managed to get runners on base, the pitching and defense was just too good to allow those runners to score. Finally, in the bottom of the seventh, Milan got back-to-back hits to score the winning run in a 2-1 victory. Alexa Higgins had 3 hits for Brashear, Harley Mihaljevic had 2, and Tana Garlock, Aubrey Blything, Hannah Reeves, and Avery Acton, and Hannah Grissom also had hits. Avery Acton took a loss, striking 5 out while going the distance on the mound. The Lady Tiger softball team was on the road at Madison Tuesday. The game was a real pitcher's duel, with neither side scoring a run through 5 innings. Then, with 2 outs on the top of the 6th, Alexa Higgins waited on a 2-out changeup and drove it to the deep left center gap. Hannah Reeves followed that with an RBI single, and Brashear held an 0-1 lead. Brashear's lead did not last long when Madison scored 3 runs in the bottom of the 6th and held on for the 3-1 win. Hannah Reeves had 2 hits for Brashear. Aubrey Blything, Avery Acton, Alexa Higgins, and Callie Altide also had hits. Avery Acton got the start, striking out 7. The Tiger baseball team also faced Madison on Tuesday. Madison got on the scoreboard with a pair of runs in the first, but Brashear held Madison scoreless in the second. Things went downhill for the Tigers after that, with Madison scoring 5 in the third and 4 in the fourth. Meanwhile, the Tigers couldn't get anything going on offense, and Madison prevailed for an 11-0 win. Wyatt Reeves got the start for Brashear, and Levi Blankenship pitching in relief. On Tuesday, BHS sponsored their first blood drive of the 2017-2018 school year. The drive was held in the Keller Building in downtown Brashear. Thanks to all the community members who came out to donate and make the blood drive a success. The Lady Tigers softball team hosted Meadville Friday. Brashear got off to a rocky start, with Meadville taking a 6-0 lead before the Tigers scored 5 in the bottom of the second to pull within 1 at a 6-5 score. Brashear scored 3 in the 4th to tie the game at 8-8 and scored 2 more in the 6th to take a 10-8 lead. Meadville bounced back with a pair of runs in the top of the 7th to tie the game 10-10. But Brashear pitcher Avery Acton helped herself with the bat and drove in a run in the bottom of the 7th for an 11-10 walk-off win. Avery Acton had 3 doubles for Brashear. Hannah and Alexa Higgins each had a double and a single. And Tana Garlock, Hannah Grissom, Callie Altide also had hits. Acton got the start on the mound. The Brashear baseball team also faced Meadville Friday night. The Tigers gave up a run in the top of the first, but scored 2 of their own in the bottom of the inning for a 2-1 lead. Meadville tied the game in the third, but Brashear battled back to run their lead back to 5-2. Brashear never trailed from that point on, scoring 4 in the fourth and 2 in the sixth for an 11-4 victory. Zane Sykes had a home run, a double, and 2 singles for Brashear. Austin Peterson had 3 singles. John Gerhold had a double and a single. Colton Sayer had 2 singles. And Quinn Allen, Wyatt Reeves, Levi Blankenship, and Garrett Hausman also had hits. Hausman got the start on Brashear for striking out 4. Zane Sykes pitching in relief and striking out 9. The Lady Tigers softball team hosted Novinger Tuesday. Brashear took a 1-0 lead after one inning and added a pair of runs in the third to push their lead to 3-0. Brashear's big inning came in the fifth when they scored 8 times to end their game early with an 11-1 win. Tana Garlock, Hannah Reeves both had 2 hits for Brashear, with Harlan Mihalovich, Avery Acton both having hits. Avery Acton picked up the win on the mound, striking out 5. The Tiger baseball team hosted Novinger Tuesday night. Novinger jumped on the scoreboard with 3 runs in the top of the first, but Brashear answered in the bottom of the second with a 2-run homer by Zane Sykes. Novinger extended their lead to 11-2 before Brashear put up 4 more runs in the fourth to make the score 11-6. That would be as close as Brashear would get, as Novinger went on to win 20-6. Zane Sykes had a home run and a single for Brashear. John Gerhold had a pair of singles. Colton Sayer tripled, with Wyatt Reeves also having a hit. Colton Sayer got the start on the mound for Brashear, with Levi Blankenship, Garrett Hausman, Austin Peterson, and Wyatt Reeves pitching in relief. On Wednesday, the FBLA made a college visit to Mizzou. The group heard speakers, then took a walking tour of the campus and were treated to lunch in the cafeteria. Thursday was another field trip day as students who placed advanced or proficient on their EOC test traveled to St. Louis for a career day and a Cardinals baseball game. The Lady Tigers were at Canton Thursday for a softball game. Canton took the early lead 1-0 after one inning of play, but Brashear hung in there until the third and the fourth innings when Canton erupted for 5 runs and then 9 runs to put the game out of reach. Brashear scored 1 in the 4th, 2 in the 5th, and Canton rolled to a 15-3 win. Avery Acton, Alexa Higgins each had 3 hits for Brashear. Hannah Grissom had 2 hits, Harley Mahalovich, Tana Garlock, and also had hits. Acton got the start on the mound for Brashear with Hannah Reeves pitching in relief. Brashear softball hosted the play to Friday night. The Bulldogs scored single runs in the first, second, and third innings before pushing across 4 in the 4th to take the commanding lead. Brashear battled back with 6 runs in the bottom of the 5th, but Tiger Rally fell short of a play to hung for a 9-6 win. Hannah Reeves, Hannah Grissom both had 2 hits for Brashear, with Tana Garlock, Aubrey Blything, Alexa Higgins, Callie Altide also having hits. Avery Acton got the start for Brashear. The Plata baseball team was also in town Friday night to face the Tigers. The Plata won no time, scoring 4 first, 4 second, and then 10 runs in the third on their way to an 18-0 win. Garrett Hausman, Colton Sayer, and Wyatt Reeves drew walks to each base, but the Tiger bats were silent. Zane Sykes got the start with Colton Sayer, Garrett Hausman, and Quinn Allen pitching in relief. Brashear hosted Knox County Monday night for softball. The Lady Eagles of Knox County wasted no time putting up 5 runs in the top of the first. Brashear answered in the bottom of the second as Alexa Higgins doubled, stole third, and scored on a Tana Garlock infield ground out. Knox County then added 4 runs to the third and then 8 more runs in the fourth to cruise to a 17-1 win. Alexa Higgins, Harley Mahalovich each had hits for Brashear. Avery Acton took the loss on the mound. The Lady Tigers softball team was in Atlanta Tuesday for a conference game. Neither team was able to get onto the scoreboard until Atlanta erupted for a 6-run inning in the bottom of the third. Brashear answered with a run in the top of the fourth, but Atlanta continued to score and took an 11-1 win. Alexa Higgins tripled for Brashear, and Hannah Reeves, Avery Acton, and Hannah Grissom also having hits. Acton took the loss on the mound. Brashear visited Atlanta Tuesday for a conference baseball game. Brashear took an early 1-0 lead in the top of the first and then added 2 more runs in the fourth. Brashear's early lead didn't last long as Atlanta scored twice in the bottom of the first, twice in the fourth, and 5 times in the fifth on their way to a 13-3 win. Austin Peterson's had 2 hits for Brashear with Wyatt Reeves, Austin Ray, Garrett Hausman also having hits. Zane Sykes got the start for Brashear and Garrett Hausman pitching in relief. This busy week at Brashear started at the 3rd annual Booster Club Barbecue downtown on the square. The Booster Club was serving pulled pork meals along with sponsoring a dunking booth, football toss, basketball, a corn pit, live music, and a raffle. The proceeds of the event are used by the Boosters to help fund projects for the school. Another hectic day was All School Picture Day on Tuesday. Individual portraits were taken. Group pictures were also taken that day. BHS held their own annual Renaissance breakfast Wednesday morning at the Keller Building downtown. The Renaissance program was designed in honor of students who have good grades, good attendance, and good citizenship at the school. The Missouri State Highway Patrol was at school Wednesday afternoon to put on a program for grades 9 through 12. The video presentation emphasized safe driving and good decision-making to keep the roadway safe. The Brashear Lady Tiger softball team was on the road Friday at Green City. Brashear scored one run in the first, two in the second, and three in the third before Green City scored their lone run in the bottom of the third. Brashear added three more in the fourth and two in the sixth to claim an 11-1 win. Brashear's Avery Acton only needed a triple to hit for the cycle that she homered. Doubled and singled, Alexa Higgins doubled and singled for Brashear, Hannah Reeves, Callie Altide each had two hits. And Zoe Blankenship and Hannah Grissom also had hits. Avery Acton got the start for Brashear, allowing three hits while striking out six. The Tiger baseball team was at Green City Friday. Green City took an early lead with four runs in the bottom of the first, but Brashear answered with three in the top of the second to pull within one run. Green City continued to put up runs every inning while the Tigers did not score until three runs in the fifth inning. Green City took the game by final score was 17-6. Zane Sykes doubled and singled for Brashear with Wyatt Reeves, Garrett Hausman, and John Gerhold and Austin Peterson also having hits. Levi Blankenship got the start for Brashear with Wyatt Reeves, Quinn Allen, and Colton Sayre pitching in relief. The Buckland-Macon County softball team was in Brashear Tuesday. Brashear took an early 2-0 lead after one inning and adding two more in the third and another pair in the fourth to make the score 6-0. BMC rallied in the fifth with four runs and added another in the sixth, but Lady Tigers scored one more in the time in the bottom of the sixth to hang on for a 7-5 win. Avery Acton went 4-for-4 with two singles, a double, and a triple for Brashear. Hannah Reeves, Alexa Higgins, Hannah Grissom, and Callie Altide each had two hits, and Tana Garlock also had a hit. Avery Acton got the win, striking out seven. After Tuesday night's softball game, the presentation was made to honor our three senior softball players. Harley Mihalovich, Megan McHenry, and Hannah Reeves were introduced to the crowd and presented with small gifts from their teammates. The Brashear Tiger baseball team hosted Buckland-Macon County Tuesday. BMC took a 1-0 lead after one half the inning, but Brashear scored three times in the bottom of the first to take a 3-1 lead. BMC added three more in the third and another in the fourth to retake the lead 5-4. Brashear rallied with a pair of runs in the sixth, with Zane Sykes getting hit by a pitch, and John Gerhold followed with a two-run homer as the Tigers went on to a 6-5 win. John Gerhold homered for Brashear, Garrett Hausman had two hits, and Zane Sykes, Wyatt Reeves, and Austin Peterson also had hits. Zane Sykes got the start for Brashear with Quinn Allen pitching in relief. Both pitchers recorded five strikeouts. The Brashear softball team hosted Highland Wednesday in a non-conference game. Highland got on the scoreboard with a run in the top of the first to take an early 1-0 lead. Brashear struggled at the plate until Hannah Grissom broke up the Highland no-hitter with an infield single in the bottom of the fourth. The Tigers had managed to hold on to Highland to five runs at four innings, but Highland exploded for 10 runs in the fifth to take a 15-0 win. Hannah Grissom had Brashear's only hit. Avery Acton got the start for Brashear with Hannah Reeves pitching in relief.
This past Saturday, volunteers from Brashear High School were on hand at Love Green Ford in Kirksville for the annual Drive for Your School event. Ford Motor Company donates $20 to local schools such as BHS for each test drive that day. Brashear High would like to thank the 80-plus drivers who showed up to support the school. Thursday was a special day for BHS students in grades 4 through 9 who met their goals on the MAP test. The group visited Jackson Country Connection, where they enjoyed a picnic lunch and many outdoor games and activities.
The Lady Tigers were on the road at Revere Friday night for the last conference game of the season. Brashear jumped on the scoreboard early with 3 runs in the first and 2 runs in the second as they cruised to a 72 win. Hannah Grissom had a triple and 2 singles for Brashear. Lexa Higgins had 2 hits. Avery Acton had a double. Hannah Reeves also had a hit. Avery Acton went the distance on the mound to strike out 9. Brashear headed north Saturday for the Schuyler County Tournament. Their first opponent will host was Schuyler County. The game was a defensive battle and the early going with both teams finally putting up 2 runs on the board in the middle innings. Schuyler County prevailed late and pulled off an 8-2 win. The second game of the day was against Knox County. Knox had a grand slam in the top of the first to make a 4-0 lead, but Avery Acton hit a 3-run homer in the bottom of the inning. The game was close throughout, but Knox County held on for an 8-6 win. Cali All-Tide got the start for Brashear. The third game of the day was against Caro. Brashear didn't fare well and fell to Caro with a final score of 11-1. Although the Lady Tigers came away without a win on the day, they got a valuable experience playing teams that they may potentially face in the postseason. The Lady Tiger softball team was on the road to Marion County Tuesday. Marion County jumped out to an early 2-0 lead after 1 inning, but Brashear scored 3 in the third to take the lead and went on to win 10-3. Avery Acton went 3-for-3 for Brashear. Hannah Reeves had 2 hits. Harley Mahalovich and Tana Garlock and Alexa Higgins and Hannah Grissom and Callie Altide also had hits. Avery Acton picked up the win on the mound, striking out 8.
On Thursday afternoon, the fire alarm bells began to ring as the first fire drill of the year was held. The drill was a success as the students quickly filed out of the building to wait at the ball field until the all clear was given. The school conducts various drills throughout the year to ensure the students' safety. The Brashear Tiger Marching Band headed to Western Illinois University in Macomb Saturday for their first parade of the 2017 season. In addition to the Western Illinois Homecoming Parade, the band will perform at Hannibal Band Day, Truman State University Homecoming Parade, and the Trenton Band Festival. The Brashear softball team hosted Green City Thursday night in a non-conference game. The Lady Tigers got on the scoreboard in the first to take a 3-0 lead and never looked back in a 10-0 shutout. Alexa Higgins had a triple and a double for Brashear. Avery Acton had a triple. Hannah Reeves had a double. And Harley Mahalovich, Zoe Blankenship, and Hannah Grissom each single. Avery Acton picked up the shutout win on the mound. Brashear also took the JV game 6-1, with Cali Altide picking up the win on the mound. Friday saw Grundy County coming to town for a makeup softball game from an earlier rainout. The game was a nail-biter with Brashear taking a 1-0 lead after 1 inning. Grundy took a 2-1 lead in the top of the fourth, but Brashear answered with a pair of runs in the bottom of the fourth to retake a 3-2 lead. Grundy scored twice more in the fifth, but Brashear got a run in the fifth and 2 more in the sixth to claim a 6-4 victory. Avery Acton had 2 hits for Brashear, with Tana Garlock, Hannah Reeves, and Alexa Higgins also having hits. Avery Acton picked up the win, striking out 9. In the baseball game, Grundy County put up 2 runs in the top of the first, but Brashear scored 3 in the first, 5 in the second and 3 in the third to take an 11-2 lead. Grundy then scored 2 in the fourth and 4 in the fifth to pull within 11-8. Brashear answered once again with 3 in the fifth and 2 in the sixth to claim a 16-10 win. Colton Sayer had 4 hits for Brashear. Zane Sykes and Garrett Hausman each homered and had 3 hits each. Quinn Allen, Wyatt Reeves, Austin Peterson had 2 hits each, and Levi Blankenship and John Gerhold also had hits. Zane Sykes got the start for Brashear with Quinn Allen and Colton Sayer pitching in relief. The Tigers traveled to Bevier for baseball back on September 22nd, but that game was halted with Bevier leading 19-0 in the bottom of the third when the lights failed. The game was resumed Monday at Bevier. Brashear quickly closed out the bottom of the third with no further scoring allowed. Then in the top of the fourth, Brashear put on a 9-run rally to pull the game to within 19-9 and hopefully extend the game to a full 7 innings. Unfortunately, Bevier was ready to put up more runs as they scored 13 times in the bottom of the fourth to end the game early at 32-9. Garrett Hausman had 2 hits for Brashear with Quinn Allen, Wyatt Reeves, Levi Blankenship, Austin Ray, Colton Sayer, and Austin Peterson also having hits. Garrett Hausman got the start for Brashear with Quinn Allen, Colton Sayer, Austin Peterson, and Zane Sykes pitching in relief. The Lady Tigers faced Schuyler County Wednesday night in the first round of district softball. Brashear started the game with some fireworks as Avery Acton homered in the top of the first to stake the Lady Tigers to a 1-0 lead. Schuyler answered with a pair of home runs in the bottom of the first to take a 4-1 lead. Brashear would add another run in the fourth as Avery Acton singled and Callie Altide drove her in. Meanwhile, Schuyler County scored 3 in the second, 1 in the third, 3 in the fourth, and 1 in the sixth to advance with a 12-2 win. Avery Acton had a home run and a single for Brashear, with Harley Mihaljevic, Megan McHenry, Alexa Higgins, and Callie Altite also having hits. Acton took the loss on the mound. On Monday night, the Brashear FBLA chapter held their annual Murder Mystery Night. Each club member was assigned a role to play as the group tried to figure out who committed the murder. A supper of baby polanzas was served afterwards. The school has a fresh new look this year after some much-needed improvements were made over the summer. The old equipment sheds by the ball fields were replaced with a new metal building. The playground was improved and a new fence was constructed around it, as well as many other updates throughout the buildings. Congratulations to the following Brashear softball and baseball players who recently received postseason honors. Avery Acton was named All-Conference First Team and All-District First Team. Alexa Higgins was named All-Conference Second Team and All-District Second Team. And Hannah Reeves and Zane Sykes were both named All-Conference Second Team. The junior high basketball teams played their first games of the season at the Green City Tournament. The girls faced the Green City A team in a seesaw battle. Neither team was able to score early, but it was a close game by halftime with Green City leading 10-8. Brashear stayed close until late in the third when Green City began to pull away to claim a 25-16 win over Brashear. The boys also faced the Green City A team. Green City hit the Tigers with a tough press and took a 20-2 first half lead and were up 29-9 at halftime. Brashear just couldn't get things going in the second half and Green City took the win by a final score of 52-11. Both teams will be in action tonight against the Green City B teams.
Brashear was hit with some bad weather on Saturday with high winds causing a lot of tree damage in the area. The school had damage as a set of bleachers were blown into the backstop fence, batting cages were blown down, and the greenhouse was overturned along with other damage.
On Thursday, students at BHS participated in a simulated earthquake drill. Had this been an actual earthquake, the students would have also exited the building.
This has been a busy week for Brashear Marching Band. On Saturday, they performed at Truman State University Homecoming Parade. And on Tuesday, they competed in the Hannibal Band Day Marching Competition. This band will wrap up their marching season this Saturday as they perform in Trenton Band Day Parade. This past Sunday, choir members from the 10 Tri-County Conference schools met to rehearse in preparation for their annual concert tour. This year, the choir performed at Green City, Novinger, and Brashear. Congratulations to Megan McHenry, Cameron McGinnis, and Madeline McGinnis on being selected for the choir. The Lady Tigers faced Green City B Squad in the third place game of the Green City Tournament Friday. Brashear took an early lead with 4-0 after one quarter and held an 11-10 lead at halftime. Brashear extended the lead 20-12 after three quarters and went on to claim third place win 25-19. Kinley White had 13 points, Haley McNamer had 5, Abby Hartwig had 5, and McKenna Hartwig had 2. The Tigers also faced Green City B Squad in their third place game. Green City held a small 4-2 lead after one quarter, but Brashear bounced back to lead 12-8 at halftime. The Tigers lost their momentum after halftime as Green City eventually took the lead and held on for a 24-21 win. Jay Snelling had 12 points, Landon Fisher had 3, Trace Gottman had 2, Avery Zintz had 2, and Lane Stutzman had 2. The Brashear Junior High girls basketball teams were on the road to Atlanta Monday. In the girls' game, Atlanta quickly grabbed an 8-2 lead after one quarter and extended the lead to 18-2 in the second half, before finally scoring 7 points in the fourth quarter of a 31-11 loss. Kinley White had 5 points, Abby Hardwood had 4, and Mackenzie Baker had 2. The Brashear boys didn't have any luck against Atlanta either, as the Hornets jumped out to a 15-4 first quarter lead and a 23-6 lead in the halftime. The Tigers only managed one in the second half bucket as they fell by a final score of 33-8. Lucas Keller had 4, Jay Snelling had 2, and Trace Gottman had 2.
As part of Red Ribbon Week here at BHS, groups of students got to participate in an escape room where they solved puzzles designed to enhance drug awareness in order to make their escape. On Thursday, a combined assembly of elementary and high school students was held to present monthly awards. As a special treat, the Brashear High School flag team performed a routine for the crowd. The Brashear High School Tiger Marching Band participated in the Trenton Band Day Parade this past Saturday. This was the band's fourth and final parade of the marching season. The Brashear Lady Tigers Junior High basketball team hosted Buckland-Macon County on Thursday. Brashear had the upper hand in the first half, leading 8-7 after one quarter and 15-13 at halftime. BMC dominated during the second half, pulling ahead 23-18 after three quarters and winning by a score of 32-19. Kinley White scored 18 points for Brashear and Haley McNamer had 1 point. The Brashear boys took a quick 7-2 lead after one quarter against Buckland-Macon County. The lead didn't last as Buckland-Macon County pulled ahead 10-8 at halftime. In the second half, BMC held Rashier scoreless in the third quarter, but the Tigers did put 8 points on the scoreboard in the fourth quarter in their 30-16 loss to BMC. Lane Stutzman had 7 points for Rashier, Jay Snelling had 3, Alex Houghton had 2, Anthony Shaw had 2, and Lucas Keller scored 2 points. Rashier hosted Green City Friday for junior high basketball. In the girls' game, Rashier only trailed by a margin of 14-9 after one quarter, but Green City's tough press and hot shooting allowed them to extend their lead to 22-13 at halftime. The Tigers eventually faded in the second half, falling to Green City by a final score of 46-25. Haley McNamer had 10 points for Rashier, Kinley White had 8, Mackenzie Baker had 4, McKenna Hartwig had 2, and Abby Hartwig had 1 point. The Green City boys hit Rashier with a tough press and quickly ran up a 28-0 lead after one quarter. Rashier outscored Green City 7-4 in the second quarter to close a gap to 32-7 at halftime. Rashier managed only 2 points in the second half as Green City went on to win the game 45-9. Lane Stutzman had 5 points for Rashier with Jay Snelling scoring 4. The Tigers visited Bevere Tuesday. In the girls' game, Rashier and Bevere dueled to a 4-4 tie after one quarter, but Rashier couldn't keep up and trailed 12-7 at halftime. Bevere had a 10-point third quarter to extend their lead to 22-7 and won by a final score of 24-9. Haley McNamer scored 4 points for Rashier, Abby Hartwig had 3, and Kinley White scored 2 points. In the boys' game, Bevere got their running game in high gear early and took a 21-5 lead after one quarter and a 32-7 lead at halftime. Rashier added another 5 points in the third and 5 in the fourth, but still fell short to Bevere 42-17. Lane Stutzman scored 6 points for Rashier, Trey Scottman had 4, Jay Snelling had 3, Aiden Shahan had 2, and Lucas Keller scored 2 points.
Seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six.
BHS sponsored another blood drive Wednesday at the Keller Building in downtown Brashear. Thank you to all who helped with the drive and to all the donors who came by. On Tuesday, the Hall of BHS took on a spooky appearance as the high school students gathered in the gym for their annual costume contest. Later that day, the younger students got to show off their best costumes at the costume parade held in the elementary gym.
Tuesday night, a trunk-or-treat was held downtown in the Brashear City Park as the final activity of Red Ribbon Week. This activity provided the kids with games and activities sponsored by the Shot Club and trick-or-treating in a safe environment, while giving the grown-ups a chance to show off their creative talents in decorating for the event. A soup supper was also held on-site, sponsored by the After Prom Committee. Thank you to everyone who made this a success.
This week marks the start of a varsity basketball practice. Athletes must complete 14 practices before being eligible to compete in varsity sports. The boys and the girls are gearing up for their season opener on the road at Marion County on November 20th. The Brashear Junior High Lady Tigers visited Novinger Monday. Novinger jumped out to an early 8-4 lead after one quarter and 15-6 at halftime. Brashear's biggest quarter came when they scored 8 in the fourth, but it wasn't enough as Novinger prevailed 28-18. Haley McNamer had 2, Kinley White had 14, and Abby Hartwood had 2. The Brashear boys got off to a slow start as Novinger pressed and got their running game going to take a 39-0 lead at halftime. The Tigers finally got on the scoreboard in the third quarter as they scored 7 points in a 50-8 loss. Trace Gottman had 3 points, Jay Snelling had 2, Landon Fisher had 2, and Lucas Keller had 1. Tigers hosted Linn County Thursday. The Linn County girls jumped out to a 13-2 lead after one quarter and were up 22-2 at halftime. Brashear scored 4 in the third and another 4 in the fourth, but fell short by a score of 33-10. Kinley White had 8 points and Haley McNamer had 2 points. In the boys' game, the Tigers hung tough in the first quarter and only trailed 9-7. Things went downhill after that as Linn County stretched their lead to 28-9 at halftime. The Tigers continued to have trouble scoring in the second half and Linn County pulled away for a 43-11 win. Jay Snelling had 3 points, Trace Gottman had 2, Lane Stutzman had 2, Lucas Keller had 2, and Landon Fisher had 2 points. The Lady Tigers took on Meadville Friday night. Brashear only trailed 8-4 after one quarter, but Meadville scored 15 points in the second quarter to take a 23-8 lead at halftime. Brashear rallied late with a 13-point fourth quarter, but lost by a final score of 38-22. Kinley White had 18 points, Haley McNamer had 2, and Mackenzie Baker had 2. The Tigers got off to a slow start, scoring only 2 points in the first quarter, and went into halftime trailing 21-7. Brashear added 6 more points in the third before going cold again in the fourth as they fell to Meadville by a score of 37-15. Jay Snelling had 10 points, Trace Gottman had 4, and Alex Houghton had 1. Both Tiger teams faced Green City at the first round of the Atlanta tournament. A tough Green City defense held the Lady Tigers scoreless in the first quarter as Green City took a 20-1 lead at halftime. Brashear rallied for 8 points in the fourth, but fell by a final score of 34-11. Kinley White had 7 points, Haley McNamer had 3, and Emma Harsel had 1 point. The Tigers were also smothered by a tough Green City defense, scoring only 1 point in the first quarter and were trailing 40-5 at halftime. Green City's scoring slowed in the second half, but Brashear couldn't close the gap and went down to defeat by a final score of 53-9. Trace Gottman had 2 points, Jace Snelling had 3, Anthony Shaw had 2, and Lucas Keller had 2. On Saturday, Bashir held their 4th annual craft fair in the high school gym. Along with the craft sale, After Prom Committee served lunch. The craft fair is sponsored by Bashir Chapter of the National Honor Society. Members of the Student Council, NHS, and Shout Club headed to Kirksville Thursday to help with the community Thanksgiving dinner held at Hamilton Street Baptist Church. Students helped set up, serve food, and clean up after the event. Both Tiger teams faced Bevere in the second round of the Atlanta tournament. The Lady Tigers took a 6-4 lead after one quarter, but Bevere was ahead 12-8 at the half and continued to pull away in the second half for a 30-14 win. Sierra Snyder had 4 points, Abby Hartwood had 4 points, McKenna Hardwick had 3 points, Haley McNamer had 2, and Kinley White had 1. The boys were outshot by Bevere in the first half, with Bevere leading 11-4 after one quarter and 22-9 in the half. The Tigers came out gunning in the third, scoring 14 points, but ran out of gas in the fourth as Bevere won by a final score of 47-23. Jace Snelling had 12, Wayne Stutzman had 7, and Trey Scottman had 4. The Bashir Shout Club was busy on the Wednesday before Thanksgiving as they headed downtown to put up Christmas decorations in the city park. The Park Decoration Project is a cooperative effort between the city, who provides electricity, and the Shout Club, who provides the decorations and manpower for the project. The Tigers kicked off their varsity basketball season with a road trip to Marion County. The girls got off to a quick 5-0 start and led 16-9 after one quarter and 32-12 at the half. During the second half, Bashir continued to pull away for a 58-27 win. Avery Acton got 30 points, Hannah Grissom had 11, Alexa Higgins had 10, and Hannah Reeves had 7. The Tigers got off to a solid start, leading 14-12 after one quarter, but went cold in the second quarter and trailed 28-18 at halftime. Bashir never gave up in the second half and clawed their way within 3 points in the fourth quarter before falling to Marion County by a final score of 48-42. Garrett Hausman had 22 points, Quinn Allen had 7, Zane Sykes had 5, Ty Gottman had 4, and Justin Leadham had 4. Bashir girls face Milan in the first round game of the Novinger tournament. A quick and aggressive Milan defense made it tough going for the Lady Tigers, who trailed 12-5 after one quarter and 19-11 at halftime. Bashir came out of halftime fired up and outscored Milan 33-22 in the second half to claim a 44-41 win. Avery Acton had 22 points, Hannah Grissom had 12, Alexa Higgins had 4, Tana Garlock had 3, and Hannah Reeves had 2. The Bashir boys faced La Plata in their Novinger tournament first round game. The number 2 seeded Bulldogs quickly ran up a 19-0 lead over Bashir after one quarter and were 41-12 at halftime. The Tigers continued to be outgunned in the second half as we played a one by a final score of 72-21. Garrett Hausman had 6 points, Levi Blankenship had 5, Zane Sykes had 4, Justin Leadham had 3, Quinn Allen had 2, and Wyatt Reeves had 1. The Lady Tigers faced Green City in the championship semifinals of the Knoppinger Tournament Wednesday. Both teams got off to a slow start offensively, with Green City leading 7-6 after one quarter and 17-12 at halftime. The third quarter belonged to Green City, who outscored Brashear 13-3, but Brashear rallied for 17 points in the fourth, only to lose by a final score of 43-32. Avery Acton had 16 points, Alexa Higgins had 5, Hannah Grissom had 3, Tana Garlock had 3, Hannah Reeves had 3, and Zoe Blankenship had 2. The Tigers faced Atlanta Wednesday night in the consolation semifinals of the Knoppinger Tournament. Atlanta took a quick lead in the early minutes and built it into a 22-14 lead at halftime. Brashear started to show signs of life in the second half and pulled within 1 point with 2 minutes left in the game. Atlanta quickly responded with a three-pointer and held on to win by a final score of 43-36. Garrett Hausman had 16 points, Austin Peterson had 11, Quinn Allen with 4 points, Zane Sykes had 3, and Justin Leadham had 2.
The fair weather has allowed progress to be made this week as crews work on needed ball field improvements. The infield is being graded and re-leveled to improve drainage. Also, the mound is being reshaped and home plate is being reset. Additional work on the fences and seeding of grass is also being done, so the field will be in top condition for the spring baseball season. On Thursday night, the BHS Music Department performed their annual Christmas concert in the gym. Elementary classes and high school students sang Christmas songs, and a variety of musicians played for the crowd as well. The performance also featured the elementary band and the high school band before Santa made an appearance at the end of the evening. The Brashear Lady Tigers faced Atlanta in the third place game of the Knoppinger Tournament Friday night. Brashear wasted no time jumping out to a 15-0 lead after one quarter and leading 31-15 at halftime. Brashear kept rolling in the second half and claimed the third place trophy with a 59-32 win. Avery Acton scored 32 points for Brashear, Hannah Reeves added 13, Alexa Higgins had 8, and Hannah Grissom had 6 points. Congratulations, Lady Tigers. Brashear hosted Higbee Monday night. In the girls' game, both teams struggled on offense early on, with Brashear holding a 6-2 lead at the end of the first quarter. By halftime, the lead had changed to 17-12 in Higbee's favor. Higbee continued to outscore Brashear in the second half and won by a final score of 59-29. Avery Acton had 14 points for Brashear, Hannah Grissom added 5, Alexa Higgins also had 5, and Hannah Reeves as well had 5 points. In the boys' game, Higbee used their inside game to jump out to a 24-5 lead after one quarter, and they were up 41-13 at halftime. The Tigers showed some life in the third quarter, scoring 14 points, but it wasn't enough as Higbee won the game 70-29. Garrett Hausman scored 23 points for Brashear, Austin Peterson had 3, Wyatt Reeves had 2, and Zane Sykes scored 1 point. Brashear visited Linn County Tuesday night. The Lady Tigers played some tough defense, holding Linn County to only 4 points in the first quarter as they built an 18-13 halftime lead. The game was close in the second half, with Brashear fending off a late challenge to win by a final score of 41-39. Avery Acton scored 18 points for Brashear, Hannah Grissom added 15, Alexa Higgins and Hannah Reeves each scored 4 points. In the boys' game, Brashear struggled on offense as Linn County got their running game going early. Linn County led 24-9 after one quarter and 37-17 at halftime. The Tigers didn't give up and scored 10 in the third quarter and 12 in the fourth, but fell short of a win by a score of 72-39. Garrett Hausman had 16 points for Rashear. Austin Peterson and Tristan Morrison had 6 points each. Quinn Allen had 5, Ty Gottman had 4, and Fisher Reese scored 2 points. And now we'll leave you with the sights and the sounds of the Brashear Music Department Christmas program.
The crowd at the basketball games had a special treat Tuesday night. La Plata brought along their pet band, and combined Brashear and La Plata pet bands performed together at breaks in the action throughout the evening. Also, in the spirit of cooperation, the Brashear and La Plata cheerleaders teamed up to perform joint cheers for the crowd. Brashear hosted La Plata Bulldogs in a conference doubleheader Tuesday night. The Lady Tigers fell behind early and trailed 21-14 at halftime. Brashear showed some signs of life in the third quarter, briefly taking the lead and ending the quarter with a score of 31-31. Brashear took the lead again in the fourth but couldn't hold off a late La Plata charge, falling by a final score of 43-40. Avery Acton had 13 points, Hannon Reeves had 12, Alexa Higgins had 11, and Hannah Grissom had 4. The Tigers ran up against a strong La Plata team who scored the first 9 points of the game on their way to a 27-9 lead after one quarter. La Plata extended their lead to 48-20 by halftime. Brashear put up 11 third-quarter points in losing effort as La Plata pulled away for a 97-35 win. Garrett Hausman had 13 points, Quinn Allen had 9, Austin Peterson had 5, Tristan Morrison, 4, Ty Gottman, 2, and Levi Blankenship had 2 points.
The Tigers visited Atlanta Thursday night. In the girls' game, Brashear jumped out to an early 15-6 lead after one quarter, but Atlanta closed the gap to 22-19 by halftime. Atlanta outscored Brashear 15-6 in the third quarter, and Brashear couldn't rally back, taking a 43-40 loss. Avery Acton scored 14 points for Brashear, Alexa Higgins had 11, Hannah Grissom had 9, and Hannah Reeves had 6 points. The Tigers and Hornets fought a seesaw battle in the boys' game, with Brashear holding a 4-3 lead after one quarter and Atlanta leading 13-12 at halftime. Brashear outscored Atlanta to take a 25-15 lead after three quarters, but Atlanta scored 23 fourth-quarter points, forcing Brashear to play catch-up to tie the game at 38-all at the end of regulation. Atlanta took the lead in overtime, but Brashear battled back to claim a 47-45 win. Quinn Allen scored 19 points for Brashear, Ty Gottman added 12, Garrett Hausman had 8, Austin Peterson had 6, and Zane Sykes scored 2 points. Congratulations to Megan McHenry for winning the Adair County American Legion Oratorical Contest. Megan will advance to the district contest in January. An anti-bullying assembly was held in the gym for the 3rd through 6th grades on Monday. Sheriff Bob Hardwick was on hand to make the presentation to the students. On Wednesday morning, the entire student body and faculty were presented with school shirts courtesy of the Student Council and Booster Club. The shirts are a way to boost school pride and unity. To commemorate the event, the all-school photo was taken with everyone wearing their new shirts. In the spirit of Christmas, the Shop Club met Wednesday morning to prepare gifts to take to the residents of local nursing homes. After delivering the gifts, the group rounded out their day by serving as volunteer bell ringers at various locations before returning to school. The Tigers made the long trip to Meadville Friday night. The girls got off to a quick start, leading 16-10 after one quarter and 32-24 at halftime. Meadville wouldn't go away in the second half and trailed by only 4 after three quarters. The final quarter was close, with Brashear holding on for a 64-59 win. Avery Acton scored 23 points for Brashear, Hannah Reeves had 16, Alexa Higgins had 10, Hannah Grissom had 7, Callie Altide had 6, and Tana Garlock scored 2 points. The boys faced a Meadville team that was taller and deeper on the bench. Brashear played a strong first half, trailing 14-11 after one quarter and 24-21 at halftime. Meadville began to wear down the Tigers in the second half and extended their lead to 42-30 after three quarters on their way to a 54-33 win. Garrett Hausman scored 19 points for Brashear, Colton Sayre added 6, and Zane Sykes and Ty Gottman scored 4 points each. The Tiger teams traveled to Trenton for the NCMC Holiday Hoops Shootout Tuesday night. The girls faced Tri-County and quickly jumped out to an 18-6 lead after one quarter. The Lady Tigers were leading 29-14 at halftime. By the end of the third quarter, Brashear led 50-20 and cruised to a 64-26 win. Avery Acton scored 37 points for Brashear, Alexa Higgins had 12, and Hannah Grissom, Tana Garlock, and Hannah Reeves scored 5 points each. The boys' team also faced Tri-County and also jumped out to an early 13-4 lead after one quarter. The Tigers extended their lead to 22-10 by halftime. Brashear continued to dominate in the second half and pulled away for a 51-21 win. Garrett Hausman and Austin Peterson scored 14 points each for Brashear. Zane Sykes and Colton Sayre had 6 each. Justin Leadham scored 4. Ty Gottman scored 3. And Quinn Allen and Levi Blankenship had 2 points each.